Hey everybody, welcome to episode 3 about reflooring the floor in our house. In this episode, it's just going to be a quick one. I'm going to show you what I had to do to remove and replace the fireplace hearth. So our family room is a relatively small family room to begin with. The builder put in a thick granite fireplace hearth. It's not really needed. Did a lot of research and found out that the prefab fireplace inserts that we have, they're considered appliances, not fireplaces. So from a fire safety standpoint, a hearth technically isn't needed because no fire spits out, heat doesn't transfer, things like that. As a matter of fact, when I pulled off the front panel of the bottom of the fireplace, you know, there's user manuals in there, there was some napkins and, you know, old pieces of drywall from when they built the house, things like that. So clearly not a fire hazard. You know, it gets warm, but you know, nothing you need to worry about. So I'm basically able to put the flooring right up to the edge of the fireplace. So we removed a hearth to give ourselves some additional square footage in the flooring area of that small family room. Enjoy. So I didn't video the whole part of this project because I forgot about it, but basically we had a granite hearth here that we're totally removing. I'm going to put the flooring all the way up to the fireplace because it's not a real fireplace, it's just a gas fireplace, so I don't have to worry about embers and stuff like that shooting out. But could not pry it up at all. It was glued down, it was caulked around the edge, and it was very heavy. It was also wedged up underneath the wood trim over here. So I just basically took out the old sledgehammer, started whacking the corner of it until a piece cracked, and then I pried it up with the screwdriver. But basically, just kept whacking it like this till it broke up in pieces so I could pull it out from underneath the edge of the fireplace. And now I have a pile of broken granite, and I don't know what I'm going to do with it. So, I cleared out all of the granite. I just threw it in some plastic bins until I could bring it to the bulk garbage dump area. But we had an extra box of this flooring from the builder, and believe it or not, the full-length piece fit almost exactly in this gap. So I just had to cut a little strip to fill in the end here. But basically, I've got 4 pieces of wood, so I had to do very little work, that's going to fill up this gap where the granite was. Here's a sample of the flooring I'm putting in over it, and believe it or not, the thickness of this flooring, or the thickness that the granite was that went up underneath all of the fireplace trim here, and when I add this flooring back in and put a piece of this flooring down, I mean, it's like a perfect fit. You know, home projects don't go like this, so I just want to, you know, knock on wood that this couldn't have been better. It's going to be a perfect fit to slide the new flooring underneath here and get a nice clean finish all along this fireplace here. So now the next step is to glue this flooring down just so that it doesn't creak or buckle or anything. So I'm going to use liquid nails and glue this down. I do want to say, as I start putting this glue down, that I was going to put a piece of plywood down to fill in this gap like I did in the bedrooms where I pulled the carpeting up. But while it's a really close thickness and it would work, when I remembered I had this box of flooring from the builder, it just made perfect sense to just use this flooring because now I know it's going to be a perfect match. So I'm just putting a bead of glue down. I'll put another one in between, mainly because this is not going to be able to be, you can't keep used bottles of caulk or glue very well without it drying out. So I'm going to just use as much glue as I could to put this down as such. Then when I tap this in. Try to get it in there without smearing the glue. Perfect. Go all the way this way. Got glue on me. Yeah, I can't get that side in. So it's more of an angle, and then I'll just fill in this gap. It's not a perfect fit again, but it's just to support the floor above it. And voila! We now have a flat floor. Hope you enjoyed the episode. And for now, the garage is closed.